I mean, I can walk up and down here, no big deal. That's the same kind of signal that's up to Valley City. This is pretty cool.
Now, are you from Ohio?
Yes.
You can't get there.
I think I looked online.
You don't have to. This is just like me. Like, so I know what you feel.
Oh, that's
okay.
Yeah, we only have the two.
Yeah.
Some of the options I'm talking to
are Thursday, Friday, Saturday.
Mm-hmm. Today, yeah, they only have one session. And they are down on half off. And if you don't want to do that today, because I think, you know, if you want to come back that way, like, the best thing to do all this is to go for a long time.
Condition-wise, it has been so well taken care of. There was a family that owned it before us here in Ohio out in Wisconsin. They operated an excursion service called the Kettle Moraine. But when they were not firing it, they did keep it indoors a lot of the time as well, and it really, really just helped it. Now, our time, we're going to scoot on down to number 33 here next to us. Now, number 9 that we just talked about, that was built by a company called Baldwin Locomotive Works out of Philadelphia, Pennsylvania. 33 was built by the exact same company a very short 15 years later. So this came out of their shop in 1916. Now, the world of a difference that we're seeing between the two is because they were built to operate in different locations in the country and they were hauling very different types of freight. So number 9 was hauling that lumber out west. But 33, this was originally hauling iron ore in the Upper Peninsula of Michigan for the Lake Superior and Ishpeming Railroad. Now this is one of our top 3 as far as size and power here in the Roundhouse. This locomotive comes in at a little over 330 tons. I know Frank has a couple things to say here at 33.
I want to take you back to 1876. You've just gone to see your parents in Buffalo, New York. You live in Cleveland, so you took the train. And now it's time to come home after Christmas. You celebrate the festivities with your family. And it's snowing up there in Northeast Ohio, Pennsylvania, New York, the snow belt. You're riding in a coach car with a lantern, a wood stove, wood car, and you're heading back home. Around the area of Pennsylvania, they need to put another locomotive on the train to get through the snow. And they continue west towards Cleveland. You've now reached Ashtabula. The engineer for your train, hears a loud crack like lightning. And all of a sudden, his locomotive is going backwards. Behind him, the passenger cars, have all collapsed into the ravine because the bridge at Ashtabula has given way. As I just said, wooden cars, wooden stoves, lanterns, firelights. 92 people perished in that bridge collapse. Well, if you were the owner of a railroad back then, it was not good publicity to have railroad bridges collapse and your passenger trains go into a river or gorge. So about that time, the mechanical engineers and civil engineers for the various railroads were getting together to figure out how are we going to design railroad bridges. And there was a gentleman named Thomas Cooper with the New York Central Railroad that came up with a loading that he proposed to use to design bridges. And they called it Cooper's E-80 loading. And Mr. Cooper based his loading for those bridges on this consolidated locomotive, a 280, a very heavy locomotive. So even today, when we design bridges, E-80 loading from Mr. Cooper is still used based on this locomotive. And so this locomotive has played a big part in engineering history on the railroads. There you go. Any questions?
What's a diesel
tank? Does anybody want to take a guess what fuels this one? No? Compressed air. So this is our only compressed air engine, also our only pneumatic. But you can see the size of the rivets on here and just the thickness of the material because of all the pressure that's having to go in here. Each one of these tanks would start at a minimum of 800. And then went on to belong to a personal friend, Mr. Jacobson.
No. Tank turn.
Oh, okay. You see where from? See, same with your problem over here.
Yeah.
They didn't have to pass the boot.
Thank you.
that there are not even railroad tracks around it anymore. So that's been the biggest issue, actually, is getting it here. Unfortunately, because of COVID and everything, we've had delay after delay. We've been hoping to have it here already by now, and now with winter coming, we'll have to kind of see how it goes.
Purposely leaving the surface.
More is better.
More better.
Yeah. Not much more than 3/4.
That way when you tilt the hill, not only do you have water in the corridor,